All right, guys, what's going on? Welcome to the Rabid My YouTube channel. And there we have it. The Ethereum merge did happen last night. I'm pretty tired this morning because it was a late night, but there is still some hash rate on Ethereum. Now, this number here is wrong, obviously. A whole bunch of miners have moved over. We'll be looking at this stuff later on, but this pretty much froze when the merge happened. Now, this has been slowly dropping over the past half hour since I've been watching it. So it was around 110 terahash. We're now at 99.3. So there's still about 100 terahash that has to distribute throughout the other coins. So remember, some people were sleeping when this happened. Others don't know that the merge even happened. There's probably going to be posts saying, hey guys, how come I cannot connect to my pool anymore? Is the pool down? Yada, yada. These things will probably kind of happen throughout the next couple days. But eventually, throughout the week, we will see all the hash rate move over. All right, so according to WhatToMine, now when the merge did happen last night, WhatToMine went down, HiveOS went down, everyone was hammering all these websites and they just weren't supporting the hash rate. I see some Ergo pools are trying to do some updates and there's a lot of chaos kind of going on out here. But we're going to base things on 15 cents per kilowatt hour. I really believe the 10 cent per kilowatt hour average is no longer a thing. Everyone has rising costs. Let's kind of see what things look like. So on a single 3070, 15 cents per kilowatt hour, we see Ergo is about 41 cents after power here. It's saying about 124 terahash on the network. Now, this was anticipated. We talked about this due to the fact that Ergo's slow adjusting difficulty. So the difficulty is not reflected yet. If you're mining Ergo and you're like, hey, this is actually not too bad. I'm still at 41 cents, 88 cents before power. This is going to change tomorrow when that does adjust. So let's just take a quick look at the Ergo hash rate. We can see we're at 188 terahash. It's actually dropped down from the peak. People are moving all over the place. So 264 terahash down here. Now the difficulty did adjust slightly, but as we can see, 3.42 upwards of 6.87, it pretty much doubled when we have about times three of the hash rate. So we're not seeing the full difficulty yet. This will hit sometime tomorrow. As you can see here, when we looked at this the other day and during the live streams, these jumps were a lot bigger, but this pretty much made them look like nothing. But you can see how long it takes. It's about 36 hours for that adjustment. So we do have to wait another day, day and a half until this happens. So Ergo will remain probably the most profitable coin for the next day, day and a half. And then once it does adjust to meet those hash rate requirements, Ergo is going to tank. Now, continuing on, I don't see any of the main go-tos in the top section here. So we got Bitcoin Gold at 21 cents after power. We got a bunch of Nice Hash here. Zelle Hash, Nice Hash is 21 cents. We got Cuckaloo here, 20 cents. Now we got some Bitcoin Z here hanging out at 19 cents. And this is the top coins right now. So that's pretty insane thinking a top coin is only rocking about 19 cents. We haven't hit the bottom of the market. I think prices are still going to be coming down. So we got some rough times ahead, guys. We got Rio hanging out at 15 cents. Now here's Flux, one of the first main go-tos that a lot of you guys wanted to mine. It looks like it received probably the least amount of hash rate so far, but it's hanging out at 11 cents. Now it's because of the price, hash rate on a network, prices are going to be adjusting constantly here in terms of profitability. We got Conceal at 10 cents, Vertcoin. Let's continue on. What do we got? We got Aeon at 4 cents here. We got Zero at 3 cents. Where is all the other? We got Conflux. Conflux is in the negatives at 4 cents. Neoxa, negative 10 cents. These Kapow algorithms are getting destroyed due to their high power costs here. So you definitely need cheap power to mine these things. Ravencoin is hanging out at negative 12 cents. That's pretty insane to think about. And we got ETC hanging out at negative 4 cents. So the whole GPU operations not looking too hot anymore. And again, we still have another 100 terahash that still has to distribute across these coins. We also got to wait another day or so for Ergo to actually adjust its difficulty. So this isn't quite an accurate number yet. Well, it is accurate for today. You will be getting this X amount today, but like I said, tomorrow or something, it's going to change and it's not going to be like this. So let's take a look at some other hash rate that kind of fluctuated over. So we have Flux here is up to 5.79 mega sols. It was hanging around, you know, last night. Let's see here. What do we got? September 15th, too. So that was just before. Merge time was about in this area here. So, yeah, we went from about 4 upwards of here. And we've been a slowly climb over the past couple days before the merge on these coins. And obviously, after the merge, we start to see these spikes. Look at Ravencoin, guys. 20.32 terahash. 20 terahash. I think pre-merge, what were we at? So pre-merge, day before, we're at 10 terahash here. So we doubled right at merge time. And we pretty much doubled over the previous week from beforehand. And then obviously the spike comes. So yeah, Ravencoin's upwards of 20.32 terahash. That's pretty insane. ETC, let's refresh here. Are we correct here? Yeah. So ETC is hanging out at 288 terahash, which I was expecting around 310, 330 terahash if 30% was ASICs coming off Ethereum. So we've seen most of the ASICs already spurse into ETC. Again, maybe the final 99 terahash or so on ETH is ASIC, and maybe it still has to come over here. Regardless, we're hanging around what we predicted to be 25, 30, 35% of Ethereum network being ASICs and the rest being GPUs. So this is kind of interesting here to see how the numbers are playing out. But again, it's going to take another couple days to fully see where all this hash rate settles. Myself, I didn't even try mining anything yet. I just shut right off. So who knows how many other people also just shut their rigs right off the get-go. Now, there's still another player in the game that hasn't actually came to light yet. And, you know, it may help us in some way, even if you want to diss it as much as you want, depending how much hash rate moves to it. So FPOW is still in its test net. It's been on the test net, I guess, since September 14th or so. So a couple days here, it has been on the test net. And once it does go live, I think it's supposed to be about 24 hours after the merge. So in theory, sometime tonight, late today, we will see FPOW go live on their own mainnet version. And depending on how much hash rate actually moves over to there, we can see some coins, you know, lose a little bit of hash rate and help pick up that profitability as it more coins flood towards that. But it all comes down to price, though. It looks like it's competing fairly well with ETC back and forth in the price wars. So, you know, it'll be interesting because ETC has absorbed a decent amount of that hash rate. So it'll be nice to see how that happens and how the whole distribution goes out. But yes, the merge has happened, guys. Profits are pretty low here, but you know what? I there may be some hope leading into the future. Obviously, people will quit mining, increase prices moving into the next bull runs and whatnot. But it's pretty much a big reset going on here. People that don't really believe in mining or, you know, are hardcore crypto miners, they're going to leave the networks. And people that maintain and love crypto mining will remain, depending on your power price. And then from that point on, we can just slowly grow from there into what could be the next best coin. One thing I do kind of want to point out here is, remember those little Ipollo miners going around? So even though GPUs were negative 4 cents or something on a 3070, we still have, like, you have the gold miner here, which is about 310 mega hash, it might even be 320 at about 245 watts. That's still $1.31 after power, $2.19 before power at 15 cents per kilowatt hour. We have the jazz miners now, so they'll all be ripping up again. So this is about 286 watts or something, I believe. So let's take a look at this. 580 mega hash, 286 watts, do its thing. $3.06 after power, $4. So we're still seeing the ASICs, obviously, which we all knew was going to happen. ETC is going to be ASIC dominated until we see some price increases there. But they're still making a decent amount of profits. Obviously, the price is expensive. They may or may not come down due to everything else, but they're pretty much labeled as a profitable miner right now, where GPUs aren't. So they may or may not lose a price tag. It's really hard to tell at this point, but you know, there's still profitability out there to be had. And I do have links to all those little mini miners if you are looking for any in the description below. But that's about it, guys. So the merge did happen. Things are changing. It's going to be interesting to see how it all plays out. We'll do another update on this in a couple days, and then, you know, maybe in a couple weeks, just to see how it all plays out. Adjust the hardware like I did do in the previous video. We'll put all these hash rates in the 3080s and see how much hardware actually came off the networks for us to still see a little bit of profitability. Are you still mining anything right now, or are you shut off? Myself, like I said, I'm shut down right now. I'm not mining anything for 5 cents, 10 cents or anything. I'm just going to, you know, keep my power bill nice and low and move on and see what happens from here. We'll do some GPU overclocking, do some tests here for you guys and see what things are looking like throughout the week and month. But thank you for watching this video, guys. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.